EJ Obiena and Patafa. How do you basically resolve this when in fact there was already a persona non grata resolution coming from the POC against the head of Patafa, and then there were the recommendations coming from Patafa, chief of which was to expel Obiena from the national training pool?
Well, the first and simple step I would consider after being more than 30 years, Christian, in the Philippine Olympic Committee, one of probably the elders, the first step on January 26th, our General Assembly, the first step is to not ratify the decision of the Executive Board headed by President Bumble Tolentino on the persona non grata applied on the athletics president of Patafa, Philip Wico. That way, in order to get that, you actually have to get 55 members, both about 40. It's three-fourths of the total membership. That will be about 40, and that will be quite difficult that might be quite difficult because 40 votes is quite a lot, no? But you have to do that first in order to save Philippines the situation now, the mediocrity that's happening in Philippine sports. First, you have to decline or defer the persona non grata on Wico. The second move, in addendum to the same condition, is once this is approved, there must be a condition that the Patafa must also now reinstate EJ Obiena to the national pool. That way, you please the NSAs, most of them at least, in my opinion, and then you also please the Olympian, EJ Obiena. So you please both, and then at the end of the approval, you just put in an addendum again that there will be a mediation for a month, or maybe 2 weeks or a month to be initiated by the Philippine Sports Commission. Chairman Butch Ramirez can handily do that. He can do that, I'm confident. And I'm sure this tragedy or this incident that became a mountain out of a mole can be arranged maybe even just in 2 weeks or maybe next week. I think mediation is going to start today with PSC talking to both, no? Wico, who I hope is getting better, because I heard that, well, he got sick a few days ago, but I hope it's okay. And then Obiena naman, I hope, will also come to terms, because I don't see any point. Alam mo, sayang eh, the Philippine sports is the big loser here. This started, you know, this could have been an internal problem that could have been solved by only Patafa, which really was exacerbated by with media. It became passionate, emotional, and you know, it has reached to a point where athletes on one side and the officials on the other side have been pitted against each other, which is disastrous, no? So okay. I would really say that on January 26, I'm planning to put a motion ahead. You know, maybe before 26, I hope and I pray may mediation ngayon eh.
I think that is the direction being taken by the PSC. So, yeah. Himayin po natin yung mga proposals na sinasabi nyo, and I think that is also the direction being taken by the Philippine Sports Commission. Number one, yung not to ratify the board resolution coming from the POC declaring Philip Wico as persona non grata. So far, you've been there for so long. What's your assessment of the other NSAs? Is this a popular opinion or an unpopular move, which is to declare one of your own? One of you as persona non grata?
Unfortunately, out of 55 member associations, I don't think this was the way to do it. This was, well, for me, over reaction of POC, it should not have been done, because you see, this is actually a problem that could have been solved merely by Patafa. But what comes out now is that if this is not arranged, or this is not resolved in the next few days, it will, you know, it will destroy both camps, okay. Both the officials and the athletes are already divided. The, you know, we have been having peace already in the Olympic Committee. That was okay. This was a good year ender, a golden year with my girl, with our girl Heidelin and the boxers. But it ended on a very sour note, because sayang, it should okay. not. It was an overreaction on the part. I think if you know, to prove to you that this was an overreaction, this is a scoop for your TV program. In 2009, there were 12 cyclists in Laos Sea Games, in Laos, wherein the POC, headed by President Piping Kuangco then, registered the athletes to the Sea Games to be endorsed to the Sea Games organizing committee. But they were denied, because the president then was Bumble Tolentino, and the POC recognized Mikey Romero. Because of this problem, let me be very, very clear. No matter how the POC insists that they can endorse, accredit an athlete to an international event, according to the rules, it's very clear. The Olympic Committee is not within its jurisdiction to endorse or accredit. Like say they are insisting that we will support Obiena to the Olympics. No, that is not within the rules. The rules are very clear. It is only the NSA and the International Federation who can endorse and who will be accepted by the Olympics, by the Asian Games and the SEA Games.
Okay. So in short, if EJ Obiena wants to represent the Philippines in those competitions, in those tournaments, he would need the PATAFA.
Always. Definitely. Okay.
Now, you mentioned
and,
that the...
And the International Federation, because okay. they recognize PATAFA and WICO.
Okay.
As so long it doesn't as they matter. Recognize...
So it doesn't matter even if this persona non grata resolution by POC is ratified, as long as PATAFA and WICO are recognized by the International Federation, it doesn't matter.
Yes, sir. It okay. doesn't matter. As long as the IF recognizes WICO, no way.
Okay.
You mentioned Obiena can join the Olympics, Asian Games, SEA Games, especially the Olympics, without the flag and the country. That happened in the last Tokyo Olympics. A lot of the Russians, due to doping violations, were able to join by as an individual, as a no flag, no country.
But and why that would is you a do pity. That? Yeah, that is yeah. a pity indeed. That is something that we should all try to avoid, right?
Yes. I think it will be avoided within the next 2 weeks.
You mentioned that the POC resolution declaring WICO as persona non grata was an overreaction. But what about how WICO's PATAFA had been dealing with Obiena, especially with the recommendation to kick him out of the national training pool, to file estafa charges against him and his mother, to kick out his Ukrainian coach, and to declare his American advisor as persona non grata? Don't you think that these actions by Philip WICO and the PATAFA were also an overreaction, if not an overkill, against Obiena?
Yes, sir. Why? Because the reaction of Philip WICO as a human being, as a sportsman, was to react to being applied persona non grata. So as human as you are, as we are, no one is perfect. If you declare somebody persona non grata who has been there, also former chairman of the PSC, who has been there for many years, and they fought in the election, WICO versus Tolentino, and Tolentino won by only 4 votes in 2016. What would you expect? I mean, I don't think WICO will just take it sitting down. You put you put a persona non grata on somebody, immediately you put him, you humiliate him, you kick him out. So the best thing for him to do is fight back, laban, and the best thing is, well, kick. With all due respect, to all these committees, ethics, whatever they have there, he could only fight back, because when you declare and humiliate somebody, he has no corner to go to. Wala na si Wiko, na persona non grata, laban siya. So the best way, I guess, they decided. I'm not part of these groups anyway. I think he reacted. Yes, of course, overreacted. Na hindi na rin si EJ Obiena makalaro. Okay, let me explain. Pareho may kamali. Obiena has some things also that was not properly done. Maybe because he was not really taught how to do the accounting. Okay, but it was, for me, it was something that could be arranged or resolved by the PACAPA itself. And then for Wiko to come out blasting, he came out blasting after Tolentino blasted the guy. So parang it became a personal
okay. Ayusin po natin tayo, no? That's true, but a lot of things also happened before that. Philip Wiko also had come out blasting against Obiena even before the POC recommendation came out.
I don't really think so. Actually, it was played a lot by sport media. I do not blame them. I'm part of that group also. But, you know, I think in spite of that initial reaction, if Patapa by itself, because there was an investigation already before everybody started throwing personal mudslinging, there was already an investigation. I think it wouldn't have blown up this big, no, ang laki, if only everybody toned down. Like, let's say, Obiena would say, ito na papeles ko sa PEC ko nabigay. Oh, and then maybe Wiko could say, okay na. Anyway, you know, Wiko kasi on his side, I think, was fighting for righteousness, okay? But in doing that, you also have to consider that this Olympian maybe have, you know, he might have his shortcomings, but he's fighting for the country. So sana magpatawaran na, maliit yan eh. Maliit yan, Christian. For me, the problem was not to be overblown. Maliit sana eh. But pumutok eh, tumapon ito ang ibang atleta, sumabay sa Patapa, ang iba. That's why itong mga pera, you know, I think that would have been fixed easily by PEC, because PEC will never turn its back on athletes, and nobody in the POC would want to humiliate an athlete, lalo na an Olympian.
Sige. Pag-usapan po natin, because both of them have valid points naman. No? Reklamo ni EJ Obiena, the way he was treated, the accusatory tone that he got coming from Patafo early on, sabi niya. No? So, on the side of the Patafo naman, of course, that's valid. Tanungin ko saan napunta yung pera, because supposedly that was government money. So tama yun, there should be full accounting, proper liquidation. And EJ Obiena, in his previous statements, also explains na talagang hindi niya cup of tea yun, so to speak. I'd like to ask you, as the head of the Weightlifting Federation, for instance, how do your athletes do that? Paano nyo sila ginagabayan, for instance, to properly liquidate government money that are sent to them for training and for competitions?
Well, in the case of weightlifting, and I want to stress this, Christian, there is no NSA that is perfect in this world. Huh? No athlete, this is also perfect. Huh? And the athletes are not bigger than the sport itself. Okay, not even Jordan is bigger than basketball. So let's be clear that in our case, we are given the financing by PAC. And everything that is requested to PAC by the association, the athletes, the coaches, goes through me to the president. Even the foreign coach, like in our case, Coach Gao of China, and then now Julius Tarano for Haidilin, I request the PEC to pay them. And the PEC pays them directly.
Directly.
The problem, yeah, the problem with old EJ is because he stays in Europe.
In Italy.
Euros, not dollars, euros, and then he stays in another country. I don't know the transmittal, and I don't know how it was being paid by PEC because it seems like it went to Vienna, and then Vienna pays the coaches. In my case, our case, I will request PSC for the payment to the coach and the athletes after I get the monthly performance, monthly training of all the coaches and the athletes. PSC pays them. I don't have anything to do with it. PSC directly pays the athletes and the coaches, also the foreign coach. Ang kayo Vienna, nagkaiba kasi Europe eh.
Hindi ba dapat gawing uniform po yung ganyang practice? Let's say, big coach, ang direkta magbayad na yung PSC or yung patapa?
Now that all of this brouhaha has happened, that is the way it will be done now, I think. This mediation will probably pull down within the next one week. I hope, matapos na ito. And I think everybody has learned a lesson. You know, this accounting, let's say, if EJ had made a mistake, matagal niya binayad kasi gamitin niya rin, whatever. Mm-hmm. Ang kailangan siguro is now PEC, I'm sure, Butch Ramirez, the chairman, knows what to do. I've been with him also in PEC before. Diretso na. Idiretso niya na sa coach. And then idiretso na rin kay EJ ang sa kanya. Then they bring back, they sign whatever, like in our case, even if Heidelin was training in Malaysia, I pay and I give it to the bank in Malaysia for Heidelin and the coaches. So, walang problema.
Paano po nililiquidate ni Heidelin, for instance?
Paano?
Paano po niya nililiquidate yung sa kanya?
Pagbalik niya, let's say after, let's say 1 month, pagbalik niya, padala. How do you spend it? Padala mo sa accounting ng PSC. That's every month eh. Yung kung anong ginastos niya, aeroplano, lahat ginastos niya sa mga rental niya, sa mga accommodation, whatever. Idiretso mo, balik mo sa accounting. Then the COA and the accounting in PC will check. Okay yan. Ito lang ang lumaki. Nagkaiba.
Pag hindi okay, tinutulungan ba ng NSA, for instance, in your case, yung atleta?
Oo. Kung may mali, ito ay magtutulungan. Kaya that's why maybe now that baka magkaibigan sila, I guess, I hope magkaibigan na sila, may kapayapaan. The PSC will check and then I'm sure Wito will have no choice but to help EJ. Alam mo, I don't think anybody would want to put down an Olympian naman eh, kung hindi ng konting kamali. Pero maayos yun eh.
Okay. Yung endorsements po, for instance, athletes under the care of a particular NSA were approached by certain companies, sports companies, or even other companies na hindi related to sports. They want to get the athlete for endorsements. May pakailan po ba ron, meron bang say doon yung NSA? Or dapat wala?
Well, sa iba siguro, hindi ko alam. In my case, wala akong pake. I mean, I wanted, after 16 years kami ni Heidelin, apat na Olympian ko siyang sinamahan, at in the end, nag-silver, nag-gold. It's now her life. I mean, she's a super millionaire. She's sponsored lahat na BDO, Jollibee, San Miguel, you know, sa kanila na yon. Wala kaming pake, maski isang piso. Wala kaming pake. It's just that the happiness is overwhelming for me na mayaman na yung mga bata ko. That's why in Paris, she will try to fight, but in case, you know, baka mag-asawa siya before Paris, right? I'm not really sure she's engaged now, but I have 2 or 3 other girls that may just win another gold for this country.
Hopefully, okay? Another gold in Paris. Well, Mr. Monico Puentebella, thank you very much for joining us tonight in the program, sir. Stay safe po.
Salamat, maraming salamat. Salamat, Christian. Maraming salamat. Mayong gabi.
Salamat po. So that's it for tonight. This has been your host, Christian Esguerra. You can watch this episode again on I Want PFC or listen to our podcast on Spotify. For recaps and other exclusive content, subscribe to the ANC YouTube channel and catch up with us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. See you again tomorrow after the fact.